Good morning, friends. I hope you will enjoy the warmth of sun in this high volume AC. In next 30 minutes, we all together will witness the new face of vitamin D. Friends, man has always paid the price for being away from nature. And silent pandemic of vitamin D deficiency is one of them. Pinched us even more when we realized that there are many extraskeletal effects beyond bones. And in the year 2009, a patient asked me, "Doctor, how did my child improve in his bedwetting after the treatment of curved legs?" And that was the first stroke to me of this chapter. After this incident, every child who received the treatment for rickets was carefully followed in an year-long prospective longitudinal interventional study, and the results thus obtained, friends, believe me, were like finding a hidden treasure. And please raise your hands if you have also observed this point, so that I may feel that you are all along with me. The frequency as well as the severity of infections had gone down. Very good, sir. The sleep, amount of sleep, ease of going to sleep had improved, as well as the night crying and night awakenings had gone down. The higher functions of brain in form of memory and academic interests had gone up, and the speech, number of words spoken, the clarity of speech, the volume of speech and the length of speech, as well as the receptive speech, what I call as understanding speech. And I'm sure that Dr. Kapse is with me in this point as he narrated his patient's story, who had autism and he improved in his delayed speech after supplementing vitamin D. Thank you, Dr. Kapse, for that information. And I call this a nature's test. Please recall the roar of a tiger from the jungle and that from the cage, and you will immediately know the magic of sun bath on the volume of speech. The psychological functions, confidence, playing away from mother, mood and fear, all had shown improvement. The skeletal muscle, the muscle tone, the motor development, stamina and swiftness, all had gone up. The function of micturition, my first stroke in this chapter, the amount of urine, the stream pressure, which means to us the detrusor muscle, the indication for control, as well as the nocturnal enuresis. Appetite, friends, every mother's delight in the amount of food intake, as well as the variety of food intake, along with the water intake, all had gone up. The bowel movements towards more complete evacuations with all its variables. Friends, after all this, I did a PubMed search to know about the world, and to my surprise, the graph of vitamin D citations had already started rising up from the year 2001. And from 2009, they rose as if to touch the sky. How did this happen? Vitamin D receptors are now found in every tissue of the body. And simple, so would be its actions. The link between vitamin D and immune system, friends, is now established. And the crux is that all immune cells have vitamin D receptors in them. They can synthesize 125-OHD in the cells itself, which in turn produces a naturally occurring broad-spectrum antibiotic, cathelicidine, which is found in all immune cells as well as the lining of our respiratory tracts. Now I know why slum children are so sturdy. Inbuilt antibiotic. The link between sleep and the vitamin D, as we had earlier seen in the chart. More work. And the skeletal muscle. The publications start from 1650 by Glisson and Deboot. He is the same person, Glisson's capsule, until the year 2013 by the most famous person in this chapter, Dr. M.F. Hollick. Friends, whenever you find delayed motor development or hypotonia, please think of vitamin D. The link between cardiac muscle and vitamin D is going to be very interesting in our clinical practice as well as for ourselves. And when the cardiac muscle and the skeletal muscle improve, the stamina has to go up. After all this, friends, my confidence in vitamin D increased. And when tailor-made lifestyle modifications were added to this, the results improved still further, because human diseases are multifactorial. Let us now take one index case from one system and go forward. And this was Mrs. Fatima. In her eyes, saying that her 8-year-old son cannot read, write, or understand whatever is taught in his school. He has been actually dragged from lower KG to class 1 by giving gifts to the teacher. I told them to take a leave for 1 year from the school, and it was a shock to them, but they agreed to stop the daily punishments from the teachers as well as to have time for lifestyle modification. And friends, I was very sure that this child is going to benefit by vitamin D. And the results. He could now read, write, and understand whatever was now taught in the school. But the waiting period, friends, was a test of patience. 1 full year. Although the respiratory tract had taken just 1 month, the growth and the muscles 4 to 6 months. Then why so long for brain? Let us understand this through the work of Dr. McGrath and others on vitamin D and brain, its anatomy, physiology, and the biochemistry. Friends, it is heartening to know that cerebral white matter is vitamin D responsive. And the oligodendrocytes, which produce myelin, have vitamin D receptors. So, vitamin D helps in myelination along with other factors. The dopamine system, the neurotrophic factors, and neurite outgrowths all require vitamin D. And myelination especially is such a slow process that 1 year time for Abdul Qadir was justified. Friends, let us now listen to the story of Kushagra, who banged his head on floor almost 100 times a day. and slapped and hit people around without any reason from 6 months of age. After the therapy, his behavior gradually came down to zero. In 6 to 8 months, along with the increase in higher functions of brain, as well as a drastic decrease in his infection rates, as usual. Even 100 years ago, mental dullness and neuropsychiatric symptoms were noted and published with rickets. And very important that they improved by giving vitamin D. Now I feel, friends, we have to work on this subject very fast and together to accept and implement things so that we may not wait for so long. The link between psychiatry and vitamin D in the year 2010. And he is the famous person, Dr. J.J. Cannell, the founder of Vitamin D Council. He has significantly contributed to this chapter, and he says that vitamin D is neuroprotective, neurotrophic, and neuroplastic. He also says it helps in neurotransmission. It upgrades glutathione, a natural antioxidant in human body. And it raises the seizure threshold. Friends, if it really raises the seizure threshold, will it help in the epilepsy patients and our febrile convulsion patients? This book called Freedom from Epilepsy talks about Herculean support of vitamin D in these patients. And the book is blessed by the foreword of our Dr. Amdekar sir and my mentor, Dr. Mrs. Parikh. The baby goyim was started with vitamin D from newborn age. And the record was till date, that is 1.5 years of his life, no medicine except for paracetamol after DPT. I hope Dr. Alok Gupta is here to listen, because he told me that he had already written to IAP for this recommendation. Friends, now let me tell you the story of Mithun's parents, who hail from Devas. They could never imagine a childhood without antibiotics, because their son received antibiotics almost every 15 days. After the therapy, the record is no antibiotic in last 10 months. And you have to listen to them to know their happiness. Along with a long list of other benefits, you have already been listening, the higher functions of brain, the sleep, appetite, bowel movements, micturition function, and very important that he had started giving very tricky answers now. Friends, a very important fact came from Mithun's parents. They told me, "Doctor, we did not believe in vitamin D and lifestyle modifications until after self-experience." And friends, let me tell you, it holds true for this talk as well as the book. Self-experience is a must before you start believing. And Mithun was not the only child. There is a long list of other patients, and if I add your data, it becomes a huge number. And why was Mithun free from antibiotics? Because the immune system became stronger. Vitamin D is now called an immune modulatory hormone, which means that it will upregulate immunity in all types of infections, help in better vaccine uptake, and also help in preventing cancers. Along with it, it will down-regulate the immunity in our allergies, asthmas, and autoimmune destructions. Samarth had a very terrible childhood. He started wheezing from 3 months of age. He went to hospitals almost 20 days in a month. His chest distortion was at its peak, soft bones being continuously retracted. After the therapy, he gradually stopped wheezing in 15 days and was free from those hospital rounds and the drugs. Friends, I shall always cherish his father's words. "Tell me, doctor, what did you do?" And this was from year 2013. Vitamin D receptors inactivation leads to hyperinflammatory response. The serum levels of vitamin D are inversely related to the severity of asthma and directly related to the pulmonary function tests. It promotes lung immunity, reduces inflammation and hyperplasia. And friends, it also inhibits the influx of inflammatory cytokines. And tell me, what else do we want in asthma? In vitamin D deficiency, very important point, the immune system mistakes harmless substances such as pollen grains, dust mites as a big threat and start with loud inflammation. We all know that slum children have very less asthma. And friends, it could be a magic of sun bath rather than the dust or anti-hygiene hypothesis. And let us now stop with the story of our new face of vitamin D, because it is a long, long list, and come to a very important point which will be useful in our daily practice. Friends, even mild signs of rickets means severe vitamin D deficiency, because rickets is the tip of vitamin D deficiency, and we need to pick up vitamin D deficiency even in absence of rickets from our history and physical examination. Just 10 days back, I got a report measuring 125 OHD. I politely rang up the pathologist and told her that we will always measure 25 OHD. She gave me a very peculiar answer. All pediatricians go for 25 OHD and some orthopedicians go for 125. I said, "Follow pediatricians blindly because it's an intellectual class." She also laughed and said, "Doctor, I want a logic." I said, "Okay, 25 OHD has a long half-life of 15 days, so easy to measure, and 125 has a short half-life of 15 hours. Who agrees with me that 20 and 30 nanograms is below normal?" Yes, I'm happy. Friends, this figure scientists found out when the body's serum calcium can be maintained at normal without overactivity of parathyroids. Then what are the normal levels and how do we find out? My favorite, the Nature's Test. The lifeguards at seashore and fishermen have a value of 60 to 71 nanograms, and 17 vitamin D experts all over the world endorse it. And if you happen to find a report which goes beyond 150, immediately get a serum calcium done. And if it is normal, do not panic, because take my words, fear once instilled in any patient is very difficult to remove. Hypercalcemia is the major toxicity of vitamin D, I agree. In medicinal form, cholecalciferol I feel very safe and of course popular. And the beauty of this molecule is that it can be stored in the body and released, converted into next step as and when required. And therefore, friends, the stock doses are convenient as well as safe. 200 to 400 units cannot even prevent rickets. Dr. J.J. Cannell has worked on 2,000 to 7,000 units to get a level of 40 to 70. Sun bath whole day gives us 10,000 units. Dr. Reen Holwith has worked for his whole life to find out the highest safe level, and he says this is 10,000. And others also agree to this. And if you find this figure as a huge number, let us convert it. Just 250 micrograms, not even 1 milligram. This beautiful graph shows that the dose till 10,000, our serum levels are within normal limits. And if you ask me about the dose, I will always give one answer. It has to be a tailor-made dose because it is a big zero in a person who works full day in sun with minimum clothes. And it may be very high in people who sit in AC hall and travel in AC cars. And we have to keep in mind so many variables to decide our dose along with the therapeutic response. And let us be safe. Take half from the sun bath, half from supplement, so that we may not overshoot. Still, sun bath will be our first choice. Why? Because sun gives, along with vitamin D, dopamine, serotonin, and the warmth of sun, which is so rejuvenating. Friends, I found out this small group in which a smaller dose is required to prevent hypersensitivity, and the most important in this is constipation. I always try to clear bowels before supplementing any patient with vitamin D. And what is the best time to supplement? Pregnancy, the most important time, with a wide range of dose from 4,000 to 10,000, and don't forget sun bath. And this is Holic, who has given different doses at different ages. The supplementation will start from newborn age to the last day of our life. Friends, we will be very careful with this wonderful molecule. We will prevent toxicity at all costs. We will maintain vitamin D records from newborn period till the end day of our life, like we maintained our vaccination records, because repeat doses given during doctor shopping by seeing the bored legs has already caused toxicity, but the child was lucky to be salvaged. No self-medication, no OTC sell, and we will try to avoid and decrease the errors which are already happening in this thing. Food fortification, friends, even in United States has caused problems. Our country is blessed with sun bath, and we just need to reschedule our school and office timings. This time, friends, we are not going to copy the West. There is no fear of toxicity in safe range. Unwarranted fears have led to deprivation of many people with many benefits of vitamin D. And finally, friends, although the vitamin D pandemic is a silent pandemic, but it is bringing along with it loud pandemics of infective and non-infective nature, and most important, the mortality rates and morbidity rates are going to decrease by this molecule. And thank you so much.
Rawat.
Thank you, Dr. Sushma Rawat. Now, we are already running short of time, but still there are questions, one or two questions can be taken.
Yes, and they were all below 10 nanograms per ml.
I just wanted to know what is the good time for sunlight, for the morning and how long for it?
Sir, again I will repeat my sentence that we will not copy the West. They say this is 10 to 3 am, which is impossible for us. I always take sun bath in the morning and we have to adjust according to our working schedules. Sir, it gives many more things. It is not only the vitamin D from sunlight, it is dopamine, serotonin and warmth. And when we are in office, how can we imagine taking sun bath? I agree with you. If you can delay your office hours, fine.
Sir, what is the correct way of taking a sun bath?
Sir, our Indian tradition, since long, has been practicing sun bath, and it was after oil massage and but with minimum clothes and it has not to come through a glass, and we have to take care of the weather, not too cold, not too warm, a moderate weather.
And how many days in a week minimum?
I recommend every day.
Every day, but it is not practically possible.
We cut it short.
I do it.
Is
good. I yeah. am doing it short since last 5 years.
Thank you so much. We cut it short here. Be there in Goa on a lighter note.
Ajay, what?
Yes. Thank you, madam. Thank you. Thank